What is up, cinephiles, and welcome back to Skrein Kings. It's time for another Netflix movie review. For today, we're talking about the musical drama I Used to Be Famous, directed by Eddie Sternberg. This one stars Ed Skrein as Vince, a desperate washed-up pop star who dreams of making a comeback. During an impromptu jam session, he forms an unexpected friendship with autistic young drummer Stevie, played by Lee Long. So, Ed Skrein is a British actor known for mostly playing villain or anti-hero roles like Ajax in Deadpool, the Arya in Game of Thrones, or the villain in Transporter. So it's nice to see that he has a softer side here, and I think he is perfectly casted in this role because whenever the movie strays into its over-sentimental territory, because it needs to showcase a couple of flashbacks to establish that this character that he plays is riddled with grief and regret, it is his affecting performance and his hardened exterior that grounds the movie, that prevents it from becoming too cheesy. So since this is a story about stardom, there are a couple of insights to be said on the music industry here, like how hard it is to find a gig, or how some record labels usually find artists that already have a huge social media following as opposed to developing raw talents. Apart from that aspect, this movie is actually more focused on the human element, less on the underdog side of him reaching stardom again, but rather on the unlikely friendship between this washed-up pop star and this autistic young drummer, and I think the movie is better because of it. Together they form this two-man band called the Teen Men, and it's just wonderful to see this supportive relationship going on, see it prosper. We have this two misunderstood musicians, so there is already a kinship in there, not to mention that Stevie reminds Vince of his younger brother who passed away. So even though they are both in different phases of their lives, Vince here has already reached stardom. He knows that the music industry can be cruel, and he's still seeking after that, maybe because of the glory that he thinks he can find in that spotlight. And on the other hand, Stevie here has no experience at all, so together they will help each other for Vince to become less obsessed with that goal and for Stevie to come out of his shell to cope with the pressures of all the noise and attention that's going on with the music industry. So this is a feel-good movie. It is sweet-natured and it might move you into tears if you have a soft spot for special needs kids who are excelling at something, like in the case of Stevie here. Personally, it didn't reach for me at that point, but I think it's still a pretty much affecting film. It is predictable. You can see the ups and downs in the narrative from a mile away, but what genuinely surprised me is the ending. They took a non-conventional ending, but still qualifies as a feel-good movie. What I love the most about this film is how it represents the autistic people. So I think a lot of people who are in the spectrum who are musically inclined or musically gifted can resonate with this film. It's all about striking that balance to present people in the spectrum to be more than just their disabilities, but at the same time recognize their struggles that goes along with autism. So I think the movie does a great job on that, and extra points to be earned for showcasing the music therapy here, how it can heal or how it can help people in the spectrum or just artists in general. In this film, they have this neighborhood music program, some sort of an inspirational drum circle. And for those who get worked up whenever actors who are not in the spectrum gets cast in this kinds of role, you will be pleased to know that Lee Long identifies himself as a neurodivergent person, and he is both a good actor and a good drummer. I think he has good dramatic and comic timing here. He's very natural and authentic in this role. I also love the role played by Eleanor Matsuura as Stevie's overprotective mom, who has good enough reasons why she's doubting her son, because the world out there can be cruel. So in here, she has a nice arc of learning how to let go and letting Stevie grow by himself. If there's one aspect of the film that I felt it came up short, it is unfortunately the music. I don't think it really took flight lyrically or melodically what was written here. I mean, I love the combination of the drums and the synth piano here, and I think the performances are genuinely staged or authentically performed. But maybe because there are only a few songs, or I'm not the biggest fan of Ed Skrein's vocals here, so I would say definitely the highlight of the film here is when it comes to the rhythmic beats. Furthermore, I didn't have that urge to go ahead and search the songs immediately on Spotify, unlike how I felt when I watched, say, Purple Hearts on Netflix. But overall, this is a sweetly crafted familiar story that deals with a couple of themes about grief, loss, codependency, and just desperation. It is uplifting and endearing watch, mostly due to the likable performances and the easygoing chemistry here between the two lead actors. It's not groundbreaking per se, or it feels a bit formula at times, but it does not scream of something that is designed by Netflix algorithm. So I also like that the film that doesn't raise unnecessary stakes in it. It's just a simple story of two musicians finding healing in music. So for that, I'm gonna give this a 3.5 out of 5 stars. This is definitely one of the better films that Netflix released this week. So if you have time, give it a watch. But yeah, how about you guys? Have you already seen this? Let me know what you think in the comment sections down below. Also, if you enjoyed watching this video, hit that like and subscribe if you haven't yet for weekly content. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Until then, I'll see you all on the next one.